An action camera with a wrist-mounted viewfinder? Stay tuned for my review of Sony's HDR AS50R. Sony's been making professional video gear for many years, and it's well known in professional circles. The HDR AS50R, a mouthful to say, is Sony's latest offering in their action camera line. It packs a lot of features into a small form factor, and I think hits a lot of high points in areas that sometimes are overlooked by other action camera makers. When you open the package, you get everything that you see before you. There are two main components to the packaging. First is, of course, the action camera itself, which we'll go into in greater detail. And second is this tiny little live view remote that you saw in the opening clips. So let's have a look at the camera itself. As you can see, the form factor is a little bit different than other action cameras. Here, the lens points forward and it's very narrow. It's got a little LCD on the side to show you what kind of mode you're in. You've also got a number of buttons here, so the menu buttons, as well as up and down arrows to scroll through different options. Powering it on, very simple. You just hit the button on, you hear the tone and it's powered up, and then you hit the button and you're recording. I found it's very, very quick to start up and to start recording, faster than other cameras I've seen. There are three doors on the camera itself. The back door here holds the multi-connection, so it's your USB charging port as well as a video cable out if you want to use it that way. You've got the bottom door here that holds your memory card. And finally on the side here, you've got a little lock and unlock. Take the back off and that's where your battery lives. Now one of the things I really like about this camera is the fact that on the bottom, you've actually got a standard tripod mount. But even better, it also has the exact same thing on the bottom of the waterproof mount. So as far as filming options go, I think Sony has struck the right balance in what kind of shooting modes they offer. The camera really focuses on 1080p shooting up to 60 frames a second to give you good slow motion. I'm looking for a camera that I can shoot good, high quality footage, and it doesn't take a ton of space on my hard drive, and I can edit it and get it online as quick as possible. And for that, I think 1080 is the right way to go. Let's have a look at the viewfinder. First off, there are a few buttons on it. Press the power button here on the left, and essentially, the camera will turn on automatically if you have it set up to do so. There's also a menu button here, which accesses all the same menus as the camera, and then up and down buttons on the side. So you can basically change any of the settings on that. So once you've got the camera on and the viewfinder on, if you want to record, it's just a matter of pressing the red button on the bottom there, and recording will start, and you can see the live view of what's going on. If you want to review videos you've just shot, you can also do that from the remote as well. Just go into the menu, select play, and have a look at the clips you've shot. By now, you're probably wondering about the quality of the video. Well, I've had the camera for over a month now, so I've taken it out on a number of different adventures and put it through a whole bunch of different scenarios, including riding on a fat bike, using it on a handlebar mount and holding it in front of me. I've mounted it on different objects to try that out. I've also had it while I was out running and cycling on my road bike. Probably the best testing I've done was an A/B test where I had the Sony mounted directly next to another leading action camera. Here you can clearly see that the steady shot function of the Sony works very well. So that's a built-in stabilization system that helps smooth out your footage. Battery life in the Sony is another thing that's very good. On a cold day, I had this and another camera out, and the other camera died when there was still about 60 to 80% battery life left on my Sony. So the high points for me for this camera, definitely this tripod mount. It adds an incredible amount of versatility. And secondly, the image stabilization, I think, is a fantastic feature that I'll be using and keeping on all the time. As far as the downsides, I'm not a huge fan of that fisheye look that it has in a lot of the shooting modes, and I'm also not very impressed with the zooming on the camera. But those are the two things that I really don't care about that much, so all in all, it's a great little package. Well, that does it for my review of the HDR AS50R. For more information on this and all their action cameras, head to the Sony website.